Hi there, this is Adam's DM, and today I'm going to show you how I painted a Boros Legion Knight, inspired by one of the guilds of Ravnica, from Magic the Gathering. As you probably know, I'm really into magic right now. I got inspired to paint some D&D miniatures in a way that they can represent some of the guilds from Ravnica. I have already painted this Gruul Clan's Satyr and this Azorius Senate Law Mage. This time I'm going to turn this cleric miniature into a Boros Legion Knight. Let me show you how I did it. To start the process, I looked up some Boros Legion related art from different Magic the Gathering sets. I established a couple key things that I wanted to follow. First of all, the color scheme would mostly consist of white, silver, gold, and red. Another important detail is the use of red at the end of capes and other fabrics to resemble flames. Because the setting of Ravnica is such an urban-based setting, I decided to make some cobblestone on the base of this miniature. For this, I used some old sprues from Warhammer miniatures. I cut them to size and then glued them to the base. I also decided to follow this sun iconography. That's when I decided that I really wanted to put a symbol on the chest of my Boros Legion Knight. Maybe there is an easier way to do this. But I decided that in case of this miniature, I'm just gonna cut off their arms and then reattach them after painting the symbol on the chest. So I got to work. I started by painting all the silver parts, like chainmail and boots. When that was done, I got to painting the cape. I started with more of a creamy white to leave myself some room for highlights. Then I also painted the cloth on the front. I realized that the breastplate has some fabric on it, so I painted that white too. The sun symbol that I was going to paint soon after would look better on white than silver. Then I got to painting all the leather parts, like belt. I made a couple minor splashes with brown, so I retouched it with white. When I finally got to painting with gold, I first decided to paint the belt buckles. I'm still not very good at painting little symbols on the miniatures, but I'm very happy with how this one turned out. When I was finished with that, it was time for all the red flames on the cloth and the cape. At this point, I also did some highlights on the cape. When all the flames were done, the only part of the main miniature that was to be finished was the face. I used some flesh shades for the face and a darker color for the hair. I'm still not the best at painting faces, and I think this is the worst part of the miniature. To make the hair look a little better, I started with a darker base and then gave it a brown dry brush. After painting the sword hilt and the gloves, I reattached the hands and started painting them. But before painting them, I used matte medium to hide the places where the cuts were made. After matching the white sleeves of the miniature, I painted some brown leather bracelets on their arms. The sword was just painted silver, but I'm not too happy with that, so I'm gonna watch a tutorial or two on how to make it look better and probably go back to it in the future. I decided to give this character a proper face or proper facial features, so I painted some eyes and some lips. Also, thanks to the fact that the miniature has a very defined eyebrow line, I was able to paint the eyebrows. I finished up the cobblestone underneath the miniature with darker gray and then dry brushed it with a lighter tone. And that's all. That's everything there is to this little project of mine. Here you can see the final miniature. And here you can see it next to the other two that I painted. Very soon my collection of Ravnica miniatures will get bigger, and I hope to update you along the way. I hope you all enjoyed this. If you did, like, subscribe, and see you in the next video.